So suppose you are having an exam in microbiology to take tomorrow, and you open your textbook, of course you have a textbook, and you find that 99% of words, or 99.9% of words, disappeared. So all you have in your textbook is a couple of randomly distributed words on each page. What's the probability of you passing the exam? It's obviously virtually nil. Our understanding of microbial biosphere is pretty much what that imaginary textbook contains, which is very little. The microbial dark matter is those missing words, those species that are missing from our culture collection, missing from our understanding of who they are, what they are doing, how important or unimportant they may be as players. It's just a dark spot occupied by unknown species that comprise 99% or 99.9% of all the microbial diversity, and we know virtually nothing about them. That's the microbial dark matter. What we want to do in the lab is A, to discover ways to sample that microbial matter, and number two, find a way to use a newly discovered, a newly cultivated species for the purposes of discovering biotech. So these are two aspects. One is more academic, how to access novel species, and number two, how to utilize them. Over the years, over past decade, maybe 15 years, my lab came up, and it's a collective effort, there are very many people involved. My lab has been fortunate enough to develop several techniques to cultivate microorganisms that appear to be uncultivable by any standard conventional approaches. Well, these are the organisms from that microbial dark matter. On the basis of this development, a colleague of mine, Kim Lewis, and myself founded a company. It's called Novobiotic Pharmaceuticals. And the mission of the company is to use these patented by now technologies to do precisely what I said, cultivate as many novel species as possible and explore them on the ability to discover antibiotics. So today, the work basically falls into two parts. One is continuous improvements of those methods in my academic lab and utilization of those methods in biotech setting at Novobiotic Pharmaceuticals. We have technologies that work very well, established at the end of 19th century. They worked very, very, very well. They keep working well. But this is a convention. With this convention, we were able to sample some of microbial diversity, and that was tremendously important. It appears that to sample the rest requires departure from convention. Now, I believe it was Albert Einstein who said, at least he's widely credited for that, who said that in his view, the definition of insanity is to keep doing the very same thing over and over, expecting new results. I don't think it's fair to say that JGI is pushing or advancing the frontier, because JGI is the frontier. It's not pushing it, it's already there. It's others who may be following up, trying to push it even further. JGI is simply the leader. That's my view of the role of JGI.